गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द सेवन चैप्टर ऑफ आर इंग्लिश कोर्स बुक द चार्ज ऑफ द लाइट ब्रिगेड रिटन बाय लॉर्ड अल्फ्रेड टेनिसन। फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट आर ऑथर पोएट लॉर्ड अल्फ्रेड टेनिसन। लॉर्ड अल्फ्रेड टेनिसन वॉज बॉर्न इन द ईयर 1809 एंड ही डाइड इन द ईयर 1892। ही वॉज अ पोएट लॉरियट ड्यूरिंग क्वीन विक्टोरियाज रेन। ही वॉज अवॉर्डेड द चांसलर्स गोल्ड मेडल एट कैम्ब्रिज फॉर वन ऑफ हिज फर्स्ट पीसेस टिम्बुक्टू। He published his first solo collection of poems chiefly lyrical in 1830. Some of his famous works are Ulysses, In Memoriam, A.H.H., The Lady of Shalott, and one more is The Charge of the Light Brigade, which we are going to study now. So The Charge of the Light Brigade was written by Tennyson describing the Crimean War, where the British army fought bravely against the Russian army. Even though the British army had only swords and the Russian army was loaded with guns and cannons, still the British army fought bravely against the Russian army. So basically, Tennyson has written this poem to describe the valor and bravery of British army. So now let's move on to the poem. Half a league, half a league, half a league onward, all in the valley of death rode the 600. So the poet starts the poem with a poetic tone, saying that the one and half a league means mile, okay? So the poet says that the soldiers are moving on a 1.5 mile or forward, one and a half mile forward, is commanding the soldiers to move 1.5 mile forward and ride their horses to the valley of death. Valley of death has been compared to the area. Valley of death means the area or the battleground between the British and the Russians. So it is a valley of death for them, as they are loaded with cannons and guns and they only have swords to fight against them. As compared to the swords, cannons and guns are much more powerful. So it would be a valley of death for them. So the poet says to the soldiers that move a half a mile forward and or ride your horses into the valley of death, and there were 600 of the soldiers riding over there. Forward the light brigade, charge for the guns, he said. Now the commander commands his soldiers to move forward. The light brigade is the army of the British, okay? He says that move forward the light brigade and charge for the guns, fire against the guns. As I told you all earlier that the Russian army was loaded with guns and cannons, so he commands his army, his soldiers to move fight against the gun. Into the valley of death rode the 600. Again the poet says that the 600 of the soldiers are riding towards the valley of death, that is the battleground between the British and army. It is a valley. Why it is a valley of death? Again I am saying it is a valley of death because they are loaded with guns and cannons, and guns and cannons would be much more powerful as compared to the swords. Forward the light brigade, was there a man dismayed? Not though the soldier knew someone had blundered. Okay, now again the commander commands his army to move forward, okay? And he asks from his army, is there any man who is disappointed or afraid or upset? Not though the soldier knew. And none of them were disappointed or dismayed or upset for going to that war. But someone had blundered. But still they are thinking that this could be a mistake, as they are only loaded with, someone had blundered means some of the soldiers are still thinking that it could be a mistake for them, as they only have swords and the other army, opposing army, is loaded with guns and cannons. There's not to make reply, there's not to reason, there's what to do and a. But still they are not making any reply. The soldiers are not making a reply. They're not asking the reason from his commander that why he is commanding or ordering them such thing, and they are only there to do or die. Into the valley of death rode the 600. Again the poet says that all the 600 of the soldiers are riding into the valley of death. Cannon to right of them, cannon to left of them, cannon in front of them. Cannon means top in Hindi, okay? So there were cannons in right of them, there were cannons in left of them, there were cannons in front of them, volleyed and thundered. Volleyed and thundered, it means there was a very strong sound of the cannon. There was a blasting sound of the cannon. Okay, lots of cannon were moving here, moving across them, in front of them, right of them, left of them. There were lots of cannon and they made a very blasting sound. Stormed at with shot and shell. Okay, so when the gunshot and all the gunshot and the shell shot created a lot of noise. Shell shot means a shell means a bomb. Okay, shell means a bomb. So all the gunshot and all the bombs created a lot of noise. Boldly they rode and well into the jaws of death, into the mouth of hell, rode the signal. But still the British army rode their horses very bravely, and they moved forward towards the British army. They were moving towards the death. The poet says that they were moving towards the death. They were moving towards the hell. All the 600 none of them from them stopped, and all of them moved towards the mouth of death. Flashed all their sabers bare, flashed as they turned in ash, shivering the gunners there. Okay, now all the British army flashed, moved, showed, or you can say showed their sabers. Sabers are their sword. Okay, they flashed their sabers, bare sabers, and they as they moved their swords in there, they created a flash. Flash means because of the lightning. Whenever if you have seen in TV or somewhere else, whenever they move their, show their sword in the light or something, it reflects or created a lightning effect. So with the swords basically flashed when they turned in, sabering the gunners there. And now they pierced or killed the gunners. Gunners means the opponent army people who were holding guns, Russian army people who were holding guns. So they killed the gunners with their sword, charging an army while all the world undered. Okay, and they were killing and all putting all the putting the opponent army, pulling the opponent army down, and all the people over there wondering that how they are only having swords and the other army is having guns and cannons, then how they are still brave, fighting so bravely. So everyone over there wondered. Plunged in the battery smoke, right through the line they broke. Okay, now because of the shooting of guns and cannons, there was a lot of smoke. So they, because of the smoke, they moved into their, the Russian army, British army moved into their lines, and they broke the line of the British army. Koshek and Russian reeled from the saber stroke. Okay, they now broke the Russian army. Okay, and they killed a lot of the Russian soldiers from their sword, shattered and sundered. Then they rode back, but not the 600. Now they shattered a lot of the army of the Russian part. Okay, Russian, a lot of soldiers of the Russian army, they shattered and killed a lot of soldiers from the Russian army. And then they came back from the battlefield. The British army came back from the battlefield, but this time when they returned back from the battlefield, they were not more 600 anymore. Okay, cannon to right of them, cannon to left of them, cannon behind them volleyed and thundered. Now again, when they were returning from the battlefield after killing a lot of British Russian army people, so again when they were returning, the British army was returning, again the Russian army was firing cannons to their right, they were firing cannons to their left and behind of them, and again the cannon created a blasting sound, stormed at with shot and shell. Okay, again the gunshot and the bombs create or explosives created a lot of blasting sound, while horse and hero fell, they that had fought so well. So while the British Russian army was firing cannons behind them, so lot of horse and hero means, hero are the soldiers, hero is being denoted as the soldiers of the British army. So the poet says that a lot of, because of the firing of the Russian army from behind, a lot of horses and hero, the hero refers to the soldiers of the British army, fell down. Came They that had fought so well, and these soldiers of the British army had fought very bravely against the Russian army, came through the jaws of death, back from the mouth of all that was left of them, left of 600. Now, even though few were killed by the, few not, a lot of people were killed by the Russian army, but still some soldiers returned from back from the mouth of death, they came back from the hell, but now only a few people were left from the 600. All that was left of them, left of 600. Now only a few people were left from the 600. So denoting the remaining people who were left from the 600, the poet further says that when can their glory fade? Oh, the wild charge they made, all the world wondered, honor the charge they made, honor the Light Brigade, noble 600. Okay, the poet says that, can anybody forgive the bravery or forgive the bravery or the valor of this 600 people and the wild attack they made against the Russian army. When the entire world wondered about their bravery and when the entire world was shocked about their bravery, we must honor the charge they made. We must honor the action they have done. We must honor their act. We must honor the Light Brigade. The Light Brigade means the British Army, Noble 600. Then he denotes and appreciates the 600 soldiers of the British Army as noblemen. I hope you all are able to understand this poem. Thank you. Have a nice day.